Hello, I'm David Brown from the Solidworks training team. This video presents an overview of a challenging and beginner-friendly robotics project, a collision detection car. This is a great way to get started with robotics by combining mechanical design in Solidworks with simple electronics using an Arduino Uno. The purpose of this video is to provide a high-level overview of my approach to this design. Due to the complexity of the project, I will not cover every detail and dimension of every feature. The key aspects of this design that I will focus on are design intent, individual components, and assembly techniques. Let's get started. I'll start with the design intent of the 3D model by showing how I organized my design in the SolidWorks assembly. The first part in the tree is the chassis, which is fixed at the origin. The rest of the components are grouped together into folders. In the first folder, I have the wheels and motor subassemblies. Notice they are currently flexible. This allows me to be able to rotate the wheels. This folder also contains the tabs that mount the wheel assemblies to the chassis. The lights folder contains two subassemblies for the head and tail lights. Each of these are made of the bracket and LEDs, which are then bolted to the chassis. The processor folder contains the Arduino mount and a subassembly made up of the Arduino board and the motor controller shield board. The collision detection folder contains the servo mount assembly and the motion sensor assembly. These are created as separate assemblies that allow me to simulate the motion of the sensor. Accessories holds the components that make up the roll cage with the IR receiver mounted on the top. The second roll cage support is created using a mirror component feature in the assembly, which is found at the bottom of the assembly tree. The power source folder contains a switch assembly that is attached to the roll cage. This has two switches mounted in it, one to power the car and the other to switch between remote control and autonomous modes. The battery holder and two batteries are located in this folder. The other two batteries are created using a local pattern feature in the assembly. The last folder contains all the hardware. I used toolbox components and brass inserts that I modeled myself. On the Configurations tab, I created several display states to visualize 3D printed components and purchase components with and without the hardware. This project is made up of two types of components, those that I purchased and those that are of my own design that I will then 3D print. In order to design the structure of the car properly, it is necessary to have a 3D representation of the purchased components. It is not necessary to have every detail of these components, only what is required to ensure form, fit, and function. The components that I purchased and then created SolidWorks models of are Arduino Uno board, motor controller shield board, battery holder and batteries, wheel and DC motors, the sonar sensor, IR receiver board, servo to control the sensor, switch, LEDs for the headlights and taillights, and a brass insert. The rest of the hardware are from the SolidWorks toolbox and are various lengths of 3mm machine screws that I purchased from the internet. There are several ways to obtain 3D models of commonly purchased parts. Some manufacturers provide them on their websites, and many user groups and online communities can be a good resource. Personally, I like to reverse engineer components and model them myself. This provides me with a wonderful opportunity to build my own library of models and helps to keep my reverse engineering skills sharp. The components that I designed and 3D printed are the main chassis, three components that make up the roll cage, a mount for the Arduino board. This is the same part I designed for a mechatronics prototype station, which you can see in another video in this playlist. Tabs to mount the DC motors to the chassis, brackets for mounting the head and taillights to the bottom of the chassis. The device used to hold and rotate the sensor is comprised of a swivel mount, a servo clamp, and a clip that holds the sensor in place. And finally, a switch plate, which is attached to the roll cage, and a mount for the IR receiver board, which is also attached to the roll cage. There are many different ways to fasten things together. I use a variety of techniques in my projects, from adhesives to hardware. It all depends on my design intent. For a project like this car, I want the flexibility to be able to take it apart and change things around. Because of this, I used brass inserts and machine screws to assemble the parts. Here we will take a look at a few of the ways these were used in this project. The motor and wheel are designed to be press fit together. The motor is attached to the chassis with tabs. One tab is pressed into the chassis. A second tab, which fits into a notch on the side of the chassis, is then added with the motor and bolted together. Only a single bolt is needed for each motor and wheel assembly. For the roll cage, brass inserts are pressed into the roll cage supports, then attached to the main roll cage section with machine screws. The entire roll cage is then attached to the chassis using the same process. The collision detection system is an assembly that clamps around a servo and holds the sensor. I designed a small clip that snaps into the uprights and holds the sensor in place. The clamp was designed using multi-body part techniques around the dimensions of the servo. One side of the clamp has room for a brass insert that receives a 3mm machine screw to hold the two pieces together. The horn of the servo is glued into the servo mount, which is then bolted to the chassis. A small screw is used to attach the horn to the servo and can be accessed through a small hole in the chassis. Also note that the bracket for the headlights shares the front two bolts of the servo mount. The switches are attached to a small bracket with screws, and the bracket is then attached to the inside of the roll cage with screws. For the IR receiver, I designed a small component that has tabs at the bottom to fit into a slot in the main roll cage section to keep it from rotating. A brass insert is inserted into the mount, and a single machine screw is used to attach it to the roll cage. The IR receiver board is then attached to the mount with two small screws. The Arduino mount is designed to use brass inserts. The Arduino mount is bolted to the chassis. The Arduino board is then attached to the mount with screws into the brass inserts, and the motor controller board plugs into the Arduino. This is a great project that incorporates mechanical design, reverse engineering, and robotics based on the popular Arduino platform. As I was researching this project, I discovered that there are many variations of this car and even kits that you can purchase. I also realized that all that is really needed is a chassis to hold the purchased parts together. The capabilities of my 3D printer dictated the size the chassis needed to be. After creating models of the purchased parts, I could then put them in a Solidworks assembly to make sure they would all fit together. I chose to design a swivel mount for the collision sensor that gave the robot a little personality. Most of the designs I saw stopped here, but I felt a car should have a body. I achieved this with the roll cage design, which also provides a way to mount switches and an IR receiver on the top. One of the challenges I ran into was, as I added functions like lights and multiple operating modes, I needed to make modifications to the motor controller board. This board comes with an unpopulated array of holes that allow for more connection points. These I had to solder in myself and can be seen in this image. For the lights, I needed to build a wiring harness. What I really like about this project is that you can make it as simple or as complex as you want it to be. The possibilities are endless. With SolidWorks, you have the tools to bring your ideas to life. Thank you for watching this video. Stay tuned to this channel for upcoming projects in the Useful SolidWorks Design Projects You Can Make playlist. And if you found this content helpful, visit the site below to access more content for designing with SolidWorks.